What is up, Sopranos fans? Kino here. It is Friday, October 1st, and I have seen The Many Saints of Newark. I watched it last night at midnight, slept on it, kind of processed my thoughts, and I wanted to give you guys a spoiler-free review of the film. I am going to do an in-depth analysis later on. I'll talk about, everything I thought about the movie, go through it point by point, include clips and everything like that if I'm able to. And that's going to come later once I've had time to really, think about things and focus them in an articulate way. But I did want to give you guys just a quick, review of the film to see if, if it's something you actually want to see or not. And like I said, this is the first watch I'm going to do. I will do multiple watches. And I also want to preface this by saying that I think if you're interested in the film, you should go see it no matter what. The show in general was so great that this movie deserves a chance from you to see it. And you might have unique feelings about it, different than what I feel about it or what any other reviewer feels about it. So, give it a chance, go see it and, form your own opinion. But unfortunately, I do have to say, I really don't like the film that much. Again, I'm not going to go into, plot spoilers or anything like that, although some of the things I'm going to discuss here might be a little bit of spoilers, depending on how you feel about it. But yeah, I didn't enjoy the film. I started out liking it, but definitely by the end, I felt that the narrative didn't really go anywhere. It felt kind of unfocused. The movie really follows three different characters. Of course, Dickie and Tony, which, you can obviously just assume from the trailer. But it also follows another side character. And I think because of this split, the narrative doesn't really get a chance to kind of hone in on like a theme or anything like that. We touch on some elements of it, but to me, they never really come together in an interesting way. But before I go too much into the negative, let me start by talking about some of the positive things that I liked from this film. One, if you were worried that this was going to be a cash grab or just a series of remember whens, like a lot of prequels do, they'll just be like callback, 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 and not really provide anything original. You don't have to worry about that with this film. There are a few lines here and there that are callbacks to the series. And, if you're a longtime fan, you'll get a joke here and there that only you'll recognize. But really, the movie tries to stand on its own. It doesn't try to, coast off the Sopranos' success. It really tries to be its own independent story. Now, the obvious question then is, will you like this film if you haven't seen the Sopranos? I don't think The Sopranos is required watching to enjoy this movie, or to at least watch it. I personally wouldn't enjoy it either way because I think just narratively the structure doesn't work. It's not something you have to be a super fan of The Sopranos to watch. You can check it out. And you might have a different take than I do. But that is one element that I thought was pretty good. Another was the casting. I actually like all the casting on the movie. In particular, the casting of Livia, I thought was really good. She hits the voice and the notes of, Livia's kind of mental problems really well. She says, "Oh, poor you." And there are times when it really does seem like Nancy Marchand. Yeah, I thought she did an amazing job. Michael playing his father's role as Tony Soprano, I thought was really good. Again, the movie doesn't really revolve around him, so don't go into it kind of expecting, this is, Tony Soprano's story just like The Sopranos was. He's really a side character in the larger story of Dickie Moltisanti. But I thought he does a great job as well. I think he hits his father's voice really well while also not trying to do a straight, Tony Soprano accent. As we saw in the show, the accent developed over time. And so we're getting a younger him. So the voice is not necessarily trying to be a copy of him. We are seeing a lot of the same mannerisms, the same body posture, And we see that the man he's going to grow up into being. I thought all the other side characters as well, Silvio, Paulie, Big Pussy, they look a little different than, you know, you remember them from the show. But at the same time, I think that, you know, they get the mannerisms right. And I'm not disappointed by pretty much any of the casting. And lastly, I'll say that the film doesn't, like, change anything from The Sopranos. It does a little bit, I guess you could say, but to me it doesn't, like, ruin any characters. It doesn't ruin really any plot lines from the story. You can safely ignore this movie if you want to. It doesn't, you know, change anything about the show. There are some plot elements in the movie that are presented a little differently than how we saw them in the show. But really, I don't think it affects it too much. And I wasn't pissed off by this movie, like, oh, you ruined this character or you ruined this storyline or something like that. It really does stand on its own, and I commend it for not, you know, trying to influence The Sopranos too much. But that is pretty much where the positives end in this review. I do have to say that, like I said, I think that narratively, there's not really any kind of payoff to what's being set up. I've heard that, you know, David Chase originally wanted to do a movie about the Newark riots and Newark in general, and wasn't able to until he combined it with the Sopranos element. And it really does feel like that. It feels like those two storylines don't really coalesce into an interesting, you know, experience. It feels like half of one movie and half of another movie put together. And they do interact, the characters do interact, but it doesn't ever amount to like a thematic element where, you know, we're seeing how these characters are influencing the events or being influenced by them. It's just, there's not a lot of payoff to, you know, what we were expecting to see with character developments. I mean, Dickie is not a huge presence on The Soprano, but he is mentioned quite a few times by Tony. But I felt like we really didn't get to learn too much about him. Even though he's in most of the scenes, and he does, you know, quite a few actions in the film, it doesn't really amount to where I thought they were going to go with him. They don't really explore his actions or his motivations in too much detail. There is, you know, there is some development there, but especially as how it relates to the two other characters, how it relates to Tony and how it relates to Harold, it doesn't, you know, end up in an interesting place. In particular, with Tony, a lot of the marketing material, and you can chalk this up to, you know, them just trying to get people into seats, they pitch the movie as, this is the man who made Tony Soprano who he is. You'll see that on the poster, you'll see that in the trailers, and it's kind of presented like Dickie is a bad influence on Tony, and he's the reason he goes into the mob. But really, that's not the story that I got from this. It just kind of flounders around. It touches on that element, like I said, but not in a, you know, a satisfying or deep way. It just, there's just like a series of events that happen. They don't really mean anything. And especially, I think the ending kind of comes out of nowhere. I can believe it. It's not like a jumping the shark moment, but it just doesn't feel like it fit thematically with everything else that was going on in the film. So I hope that wasn't too much of a spoiler for you guys so far. Again, I will make a review probably later this month in depth, go through point by point, and I will talk about spoilers then. But for now, I just wanted to give you my first impression. Like I said, I only watched it one time. I will watch it more times and try to process it more, and I might come away thinking differently than I do right now. But yeah, ultimately, not a great experience for me, and we'll see where it goes from here. I mean, David Chase has said that he would be interested in doing another movie, particularly if he is able to work with Terry Winter, who was a writer on The Sopranos starting in season two. I would be interested in seeing that, because I think Terry is one of the best writers on The Sopranos. And it might have just been a case that Chase needed someone to help him kind of focus the storyline and focus it more on the actual characters that we care about. But yeah, I would see a sequel to this. But ultimately, not too happy with this one. But I'm still grateful for the show and the movie for existing. Obviously, I owe a lot to this series and to David Chase himself. So that's why, again, I reiterate, please go see the movie. Go check it out for yourself. Form your own opinion. And hopefully come back for my review so we can actually discuss and go through point by point. I look forward to talking with you guys then, and I'll see you soon. Thanks.